This is a site called Before It's News. They have a lot of great articles on just about everything that you can think of. This one caught my eye, called Are We in a HAARP Earthquake War? This says, the United States Congressional Record deals with the use of HAARP for penetrating the Earth with signals bounced off the ionosphere. These signals are used to look inside the planet to a depth of many kilometers in order to locate underground munitions, minerals, and tunnels. The U.S. Senate set aside $15 million in 1996 to develop this ability alone, Earth penetrating tomography. The problem is that the frequency needed for Earth penetrating radiation is within the frequency range most cited for disruption of human mental functions. It may also have profound effects on migration patterns of fish and wild animals, which rely on undisturbed energy fields to find their routes. As if electromagnetic pulses in the sky and mental disruption were not enough, T. Eastland bragged that the super powerful ionospheric heater could control weather. This goes on to say this, a lot of other information, but I was particularly drawn to this gentleman's analysis, and that is the one, I'm going to scroll down here real quick, let's see, it says, Japan is moving towards breaking ties with the U.S. The earthquake took place the day after the article broke. I'm going to say that again. Japan's earthquake took place the day after the article came out. The video shows that Japan has been threatened before by our earthquake machine. This one could have also been a Russian HAARP job that targeted the Okinawa military installation. So let's click on this and see. This one is Japan rethinks its U.S. relationship. Can't say as I blame them. Okay. Okay. This talks about our relationships with Japan and the treaty that we signed. The Democratic Party of Japan promised to end decades of passive behavior in dealings with the U.S. Hatoyama, after taking over as prime minister, showed that he was serious about Japan following an Asia-oriented foreign policy. His government is giving special emphasis to a strong relationship with China, India, and other Asian countries. On January 19th, the 50th anniversary of Japan-U.S. Security Treaty was commemorated in Tokyo. Japan and the U.S. signed the Military Pact in 1951. It was revised in 1960. The treaty had a clause that allowed the U.S. to intervene in case of large-scale internal riots and disturbance in Japan. Basically, that means let us stay in there, just get our feet in there. One of the clandestine clauses made Japan pay for the maintenance of U.S. bases that we have in Japan. On the occasion of the anniversary, Hatoyama stressed the importance of the Security Pact for peace and stability in the region, even as hectic behind-the-scenes diplomatic activity went on to decide the fate of the U.S. Futenma Air Base in Okinawa. Indications are that the Hatoyama government is keen to end the U.S. military presence there. The Obama administration has taken a tough stance on the issue, insisting that U.S. presence in Okinawa is crucial for the security of the East Asian region. Okinawa is home to 75% of the 53,000 U.S. troops based in Japan. The Obama administration signaled that it could backtrack on an earlier U.S. $26 billion deal involving the transfer of 6,000 U.S. troops from Okinawa to Guam if the Hatoyama administration decided to close the airbase. The deal agreed 4 years ago also involved handing back to Japan valuable real estate in thickly populated Okinawa City. In November last year, U.S. Defense Secretary Robert Gates warned Japan that it would face serious consequences if the new government did not honor the commitments on the basis given by the former government. During his visits, Gates loudly lobbied for an extension of the military bases agreement. The Japanese media were openly critical of Gates, describing the defense secretary as a bully. But since then, both sides have adopted a more diplomatic stance. Well, it seems to make things a little bit more clear for me. It makes me ashamed sometimes to be an American and not have any control over what my government does. Of course, they're killing us too, so. But, you know, that's what the Illuminati is all about. Need I say more? God bless.